whatever.
Second date update.
That guy's a cheater.
I'm just manifesting.
Ooh, it's Confession Wednesday.
Tell us your secrets.
It's the John and Chantel Radio Podcast.
It's a podcast?
It's a podcast.
Oh.
John and Chantel's Radio Podcast.
It is Tuesday. Good morning. I'm John. She's Chantel.
Morning.
Morning, Chantel. Good morning, Jake. Well, if I turn on your
hello. There we go.
Is it rain? Oh, it is raining.
Yes.
It is raining.
I've not looked around in quite some time.
Yeah?
The last time I did, the rain had not started falling yet.
Yeah, no,
oh, really?
Yeah. It's slick out there enough that it's kind of making traffic slow down.
Okay.
Yeah,
so there
true.
You go. Today, rain in the valley, snow up in the mountains, 44 is the high. Temps are going to change for tomorrow, but that's what we're dealing with right now. If it's safe and you have a traffic update for us, please always do text us at 844-649-1051. I don't know this about you, Jake.
Oh?
Chantel, we just learned something new about Jake.
Oh, did we?
Oh, boy.
He's a picklehead. A pickler.
A pickler?
Pickle boy.
You pickle?
A pickle boy.
You pickle things?
I don't know what.
What does that mean?
What is the term? You've become a pickleball.
Ah, pickleball.
Pickleballer.
Let me tell you, I detest the veggie.
No, you don't like the pickles.
I'm not a pickle guy.
Interesting.
I love pickles.
Same.
But pickleball, that's quite the contrary.
Okay, isn't it kind of fun?
Yeah, it's awesome.
Yeah, I played it for the first time last summer.
But here's what I don't understand. What's the difference between that and tennis?
Well, tennis uses a full racket, and pickleball uses a paddle.
Okay,
you also run in tennis. Pickleball,
is that
kinda...
it?
No, there's like rules in pickleball. There's like a kitchen.
Oh, the kitchen.
There's a kitchen?
Stay out of the... Oh, you didn't play real pickleball.
Yeah,
no, I guess not. It was amateur pickleball.
If your first question is there a kitchen, you don't pickle.
I didn't know there was cooking involved.
There's a bunch of
rules.
There's
a lot
bunch
of rules.
Oh, man.
I've played in a few like open tournaments.
Uh-huh.
And let me tell you right now, some people are way too intense about their
real picklers. Also feel like the way like pickleball has the rules, it's just like too much.
We need less rules.
It's like, okay, I get it. They served last time. We didn't switch spots.
Uh-huh.
Like, yada, yada, yada.
I was placed with this old man who was yelling at me constantly for breaking the rules.
Naturally.
And I wanted to turn to him and say, we are using a wiffle ball.
Literally.
Like, why are you taking this so seriously?
Exactly. Like, come on now.
It's an oversized
the game is called pickleball.
You're 87. You're able to do this. This isn't an Olympic sport.
Tennis? That's okay.
Yes.
That's
right.
Got some
100%
elegance behind it. Pickleball? It's for children. It's awesome.
I do love it. Don't get me wrong.
No, it was great.
But let's all just calm down a bit. You get
as Taylor
there,
said, you need to calm down.
You go to like a, I mean, the weather's changing now, but over summer, you try to get to a pickleball court.
Good
luck. No, we had to wait in a queue.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, the courts were full.
Now, did you wait for the whole court, or were you just trying to play in?
We were just trying to get in a court.
Okay, so you're trying for the whole.
Yeah.
Well, sometimes you just only get your spot. It's like waiting for your time at pool.
Yeah.
You're playing the winner.
Right,
but you
right,
didn't
right.
have that yet.
No.
All right, so you're a brand new picklehead.
I guess I got to look at the actual rules though.
Yeah, learn about the kitchen
before I fully call myself a picklehead.
Once you understand how many cooks are in the kitchen and all
please.
That, you're gonna love it.
And that's a real rule.
Yes.
Okay, great. There's
I think
cooks.
So.
The chefs.
The old man told me so when he was scolding me.
Yeah.
Was this a real guy?
Yes, okay. This was a real guy. All right, we'll start with on this day in pop culture history, and then we'll get going for you. It was on this day in 1993, the first Ultimate Fighting Championship event.
Oh, no way.
UFC 1 was held in Denver, Colorado. When UFC began... You had to watch a lot of these like on VHS.
Like pay-per-view.
Yeah. And they were rated like X because of how violent they were. There were no rules in the octagon and people got really
And that was the
hurt.
Whole thing with it.
Oh yeah. It was like underground fighting and that's where
Really?
Yeah. And slowly as it evolved and became more popular, they started to have like more of a governing board and it became what we see now with UFC, 273.
Right.
Yeah, so.
Wow.
And Chantel's a new fan of UFC.
New fan? I went to UFC for the first time, but I've been watching UFC since high school.
Really?
Yeah, I come from a wrestling family.
I'm not buying it. Mm-hmm. That's the way I'm not buying Jake's a pickleball player.
All right.
Not buying anything today.
In 2004, there is a jury in Redwood City, California, who convicted Scott Peterson. This is crazy. I'm bringing this up. because he's actually in the appeals process right now. So Scott Peterson was convicted of murdering his pregnant wife, Lacey Peterson, 2004. Now, there's been all of these podcasts saying, was it really just some kind of serial killer roaming around Redwood City at the time? And Scott Peterson was...
Got framed,
kind of for it. It was just the easy person to pin. If you don't know much about him, he's the guy who decided at one point to dye his beard and his hair blonde and try to drive across the Mexican border.
Oh.
So that doesn't make you look great.
No.
To his defense, he's going, everyone was already pointing at me. I knew my time was numbered. I was just... Wow. So if you don't know a lot about it, go find one of those podcasts right now. I think he did it. I don't think he's innocent by any means, but yeah. Mm-hmm. And then it was on this day in 2011, Rihanna had a number one.
Without love, oh, yeah. Without love, in a hopeless
place. Featuring?
I have no idea.
Calvin Harris.
Okay.
Calvin Harris, We Found Love. This song stayed number one from November 12, 2011. To January 6, 2012.
It's wild that there was an era of pop that was like, hey, we're going to the club.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Like,
me and my brother were listening to
much power.
A bunch of that 2010 stuff. It was such a party era.
We just party rock anthem.
Well,
this.
When this song came out on the same album, was This Is Where We Came From?
Yeah.
Which is written by Taylor Swift.
Yes.
So even she was getting into like the club tunes at the time.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was wild.
I believe she wrote it while she was dating Calvin Harris.
I think you're right.
There you go. All right, let's go. We're ready for you. Are you ready for us? That's the question. What do you have coming up, Chantel?
We are going to talk what's trending. Well, let's do it. Let's talk what's trending. Man, it was an exciting day yesterday because there's a huge announcement. Megan Fox, Machine Gun Kelly, expecting their first child together.
Yeah, I was shocked by this news.
I thought they broke up.
Okay.
Oh. I thought they broke
up. Same.
I was so confused when I saw this. She is expecting her first child together with Machine Gun Kelly. This will be her third. She has three sons with Brian Austin Green. Their ages are 7, 9, 11. Machine Gun Kelly has a 15-year-old with his daughter with his ex-girlfriend.
Look, I think it's exciting other than the fact that they seem to have a very tumultuous
up and down.
Yeah.
So.
Just hope the baby wasn't there to save the relationship. Yeah.
Or it wasn't as much of a surprise to them as it was to us. I don't know.
I did see her announcement, though. She was like covered in all that black goo.
Yeah. Also in the baby department, Chris Pratt, Katherine Schwarzenegger, they announced they just had their third baby.
No kidding.
All right.
I know. Isn't that so cute? They have now a infant, a 2-year-old, a 4-year-old, and a 12-year-old.
12-year-old is Anna Faris.
Yes, it's Chris Pratt's from a previous relationship. Anyway, I think that's so exciting.
Yeah, that's cool.
Also, we had the announcement of Sexiest Man Alive nominations. And there's a frenzy that Selena Gomez has paid for Benny Blanco to be listed as Sexiest Man Alive. And I think this is amazing. It's for People Magazine.
Yeah.
I know a lot of people like campaigning for this year. I've never seen the campaigning before.
You mean like celebrities like trying to do posts or something?
Yeah. Or just other radio hosts. Or
you can't ask for it.
TV personalities. Yeah. Anyway, we'll see. Sexiest Man Alive in 2024 has yet to be claimed. In 2023, it was Patrick Dempsey. 2022 is Chris Evans.
Wait, I'm sorry. What's the deal with Benny Blanco, though, with all this? Like, what is the... campaigning? Or I don't understand. What is it?
Do you think he's the sexiest man alive?
He's a stud. He's got Selena Gomez.
Let
me take a look here. Let me just make sure.
Fresh reminder. Take a fresh look.
I mean, you got Chase Stokes.
With morning eyes.
I think that if you want the average looking dude.
He's a musician, right?
He's a producer.
Yeah.
I would say he's the average looking guy. Yeah,
he's
no.
He's definitely, yeah, no.
Yikes.
Selena Gomez is not the average looking girl.
No. Yeah.
Wow.
So do I need to say anymore?
No.
So wait, there's controversy over this?
Yeah, that Selena Gomez getting? Is paying for it.
It's not even controversy. It's people just being mean. Yeah. It's just people saying, no,
truly.
Nobody.
Nope.
It's okay.
I'm just saying there's a few other options. And then the trailer for Mission Impossible 8 was released yesterday.
When the need for certainty is absolute and the odds are deemed impossible, the mission falls to him.
Should he choose to accept?
Oh! I'm so excited.
I know. Mission Impossible 8, Dead Reckoning. Or sorry, that was...
Dead Reckoning.
This is Final Reckoning.
This is Final Reckoning, sorry. It was originally scheduled to release May 23rd, 2025. Sorry, it was originally set for 2022.
Okay.
It's now being released May 23rd, 2025.
I don't think the last one did well.
It did.
It did it?
It did.
It kind of got sandwiched in between...
the Barbie and the Oppenheimer stuff. Yeah.
Yeah, so it didn't do as well as it could have, but... and I think that's what made it delayed that second release, part two.
And that's what's trending.
All right, thank you, Chantel. Coming up next, we'll check in with yesterday's John and Chantel's Hot Topic. Gracie Abrams, Mix 105.1, John and Chantel. And we've got Karen in Orem who's listening, saying the rain is falling. Thanks for that, Karen in Orem. Appreciate it.
I want to look back at yesterday's Hot Topic. We were talking about Whoville noses.
Right.
Would you get a nose job to look like a who?
Yes.
97% of people say, no way.
So when it trends like this on TikTok, do you think most people are just sharing it going, nope?
Yeah. Yes.
One of those kind
like,
of things?
Like, this is ridiculous.
Like, right now I've got my my stepmom staying with us, and she heard us talking about it, and she ended up Googling and looking up like Whoville noses to see if this was a thing. And I'm like, Chantel had a photo up on the Insta story about it. Like, this is, what was the angle?
It was 123 degrees.
Boom. What, they took a protractor.
Wow. Yeah.
The nose was 123 degrees.
They said, to be fair, we usually go for 90 to 113 degrees.
Well, sure.
So 123, that's why it looks bad.
Ah.
Got it.
Sure. Coming up next, a brand new John and Chantel's Hot Topic has to do with Thanksgiving dinner and what you're wearing. Right now, though, it's time for John and Chantel's Hot Topic. If you are new to the show, first of all, welcome. The Hot Topic is just a daily poll that we put up on Instagram. Instagram handle is at Mix1051Utah. This was a conversation we were having yesterday. I was in class. And we started talking Thanksgiving.
Yeah.
Thanksgiving is 16 days away.
Oh, wow. I can't believe it.
Yeah.
You know what that means? My birthday is...
Less than that?
Less than that. It's...
Okay.
13 days?
13 days away.
I got you. So Thanksgiving dinner, you're there, you're with family, the turkey's waiting to be carved by dear old dad at the edge of the table, right?
Ah. Mm-hmm.
And you look at yourself in the mirror, what are you wearing? Do you dress casual or do you dress fancy
for Thanksgiving?
At the Thanksgiving table?
My dream would be to dress up.
You want
to
be fancy?
Yeah, but I come from a lounge family, so we're definitely like wear something comfy. You're settling in for the long day at mom and dad's house.
Yeah,
watching some football, eating like appetizers before the meal,
right?
Desserts after the meal. Like it's a long day.
How comfy can you get? Can you wear sweats?
Yeah.
Okay.
Really?
All the way.
You could wear like my mom will always be wearing something nicer.
Yeah.
Like. A nice blouse and a jeans or whatever.
Yeah.
But like the kids are in sweats.
Okay.
I would be wearing like primo golf apparel, like joggers.
Yeah, something
and like
with an elastic band.
Yeah, but definitely with some elastic.
Yeah, some give.
I can't believe.
Yeah, but
it.
Sweats would be fine in my family.
Jake, what do you do at the subs house?
Zero formality at all. That's crazy.
Yeah.
We have to dress up at least a little bit. You know?
So are you talking like a collared shirt?
Yeah, but I go for like comfort fancy. Where I go for like a collared shirt, but like a comfy sweater. You know what I mean?
All right.
I'm still going to wear pants. I'm not wearing sweats.
Yeah.
But
okay.
Something that's
judged.
Still warm and cozy, you know?
Could you get away with a hoodie or is that too casual for Thanksgiving?
Maybe
dinner?
Later. Maybe in the evening.
I'm talking when you sit down at the no hoodie allowed.
I think if one of us wore sweats, we would be asked to change.
Yeah. Oh.
Honestly.
Like, yeah. This past Sunday, my family celebrated Thanksgiving because we all are going different directions for the actual holiday. And my boyfriend texted me. He's like, hey, what are we supposed to wear? And I was like,
Whatever you want. Yeah.
Lounge. You can wear, like, most everybody was wearing Chiefs, like, clothing.
Because it was Sunday.
Right.
Because it was Sunday. And I was like, just for the record, the only person in my family who wishes there was a dress code in anything in life is me. So you don't need to worry, ever.
We're like, my family, we're like Jake's house.
Yeah?
You gotta dress up.
God, it's so fun.
Yeah.
Do you have company your over?
Family. Yeah, we usually always have a few people over.
So do we.
And you wear, at least a collared shirt and jeans or something.
Like my dad will wear a polo. Maybe it's the kids that are the problem. Like me, the siblings.
Yeah, everyone else is dressed up. Chantel's just never realized it.
I realized my sister was in a cute, sister was wearing a very cute matching sweat set.
Okay. Now.
I was wearing a, very nice Chiefs sweater.
Yeah.
Whatever that nice sweater fabric is.
Okay.
And, some really nice jeans with cowboy boots. So, I mean, I dressed up.
Hoodie wouldn't, like you, hoodie would not be allowed.
Hoodie wouldn't cut it.
No, wouldn't cut it at the
Thanksgiving
dinner.
Sweater is towing the line because.
Depends on the sweater.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, see, I'd love to wear one of those really cute Thanksgiving outfits you see on Pinterest.
Right.
Yeah.
Do it.
Yeah.
I dare
Maybe
you.
Maybe I will.
Set the trend.
I'm going to my boyfriend's for actual Thanksgiving.
Definitely.
And if there's no dress code, I'm going to be disappointed.
Dressing casual or fancy at the Thanksgiving table, what does your family do? 16 days. It's time to start having that conversation now so you don't get embarrassed.
Take it out.
Hey, we'll follow up with the Hot Topic next hour at 7:50. Coming up next, we're going to get to know each other a little bit better. Oh, dang. Did you hear that Sabrina Carpenter concert story from yesterday?
Yeah,
no.
I did.
Good morning, by the way. John and Chantel, number one for all the hits, Mix 105.1. Allegedly, someone in the pit of a Sabrina Carpenter concert decided the bathroom was too far away.
They had an accident.
Yeah.
I heard this. That's disgusting.
Right?
Yeah, it is.
Inappropriate.
Not in my pit.
No. Not in the Sabrina Carpenter pit.
If you're going to tell me, what band had a fan go to the bathroom in the pit, I'd be like, I don't know, Blink-182,
Korn,
Limp Bizkit,
Iron Maiden,
Sabrina Carpenter. Yeah.
The girl having a sleepover party on stage.
Hey, if you're new to the show, welcome. Putting it my way. But over the last week, we've been kind of reacquainting ourselves with one another.
Yeah.
Asking getting to know you questions. Of course, if you want to share your answers, you're always welcome as well by just texting us at 844-649-1051. I asked ChatGPT for just a bunch of getting to know you questions.
Love it.
What do you do to get out of a bad mood?
I listen to music, personally.
I was gonna say probably
music. Listen to my favorite tunes.
Okay. Is there a specific band?
It depends on the mood I'm trying to get out of. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's anger. You got to listen to some Beastie Boys, some Rage, King Gizzard. You know?
Okay. Chantel?
If not music, then I would say watching a comedy, a movie.
Yeah.
Working out would be if I could get to a gym like that by far. After that, listening to either some kind of comedy podcast or.
Something to change the pace.
Mm-hmm. Have you ever sent a dirty text? As you know, I've been trying, I keep getting rejected by my wife.
Yep.
I keep throwing it out there, keep serving the ball, that's as far as it gets.
Just because the door's open.
Doesn't mean you have to walk through.
Nope.
Have you really lived until you've sent a dirty text?
I guess I have not lived.
I guess, no.
No.
No, yeah.
Yeah?
Sure. I was like, Jake? Yeah.
Oh,
don't
I bet
lie
Jake.
To the people.
Yeah.
I've been in exclusively long-distance relationships.
Jake, do you keep your face out of those photos if you're sending something, or do you leave your face in there? That's what I'm curious.
I think that's a little too personal.
Do you put an emoji over your face to? Is that how it works?
What's the filter?
Baby face?
Yeah.
Is that what you do?
Make it the Giga Chad face?
Gosh. My mother listens to this show.
I know. So does mine.
Come on. Why do you do this to us?
I'm sorry we're having an adult conversation around here,
Ridiculous.
Getting to know each other as people.
Oh, someone's going to blackmail me. I'm kidding.
I know this answer for the two of you, I think. What is something you eat every single day?
Simple.
Yeah.
A Red Bull.
Yeah.
Does that count?
For a while there, you went through a Muddy Buddy phase that was quite impressive.
Oh, yeah.
Man,
there was like a 2-year Muddy Buddies.
Well, yeah. They stopped putting them in the cantina.
Is that what happened?
Yes. So then I had to switch to the donuts.
Yes.
And then I switched to the Pop-Tart. And now I don't know what I want. Like yesterday I had a Core Power, like some sort of healthy girl.
Didn't feel right.
Weird.
Didn't feel right.
Jake, you do a Celsius every day.
Come on now.
And an Uncrustable.
This is a double shot of freedom right here.
It is. Have you tried the new raspberry Uncrustable?
I have not.
It's fantastic.
But I tried a grape Celsius yesterday, and it was very weird.
Hmm.
Why?
Yeah.
It's just uncanny. Threw me off. It's not grape soda, and it's not cough medicine. It's like a weird in-between.
Does it taste like a Jolly Rancher?
Kinda. Okay. But Jolly Ranchers are better.
Grape Jolly Ranchers are underrated.
Yes.
I eat an apple every single day.
I know you do.
Yeah.
He honestly thinks it'll keep the doctor
doctors
away.
Hate him.
The doctors stay away from me in such a way that,
yeah.
Like a vampire and
you
garlic.
You walk in and they go, oh, great. The guy who eats an apple every day.
I like to think I would be healthier than I am.
You seem pretty healthy.
No, John tries the hardest.
I do.
Yes,
He's a try hard.
And I'm the one who's going to die first.
Yes,
and it's
you
not
are.
Fair.
It isn't fair.
It's not fair.
It's really not.
Like, that's ridiculous. I always say Grandma Dolores is 87 and she's going to outlive me.
Yeah.
And she hasn't made a good healthy choice in about 30 years.
She hasn't had an apple since the 30s.
It's the people who drink a Diet Coke every day.
I know. It's ridiculous. All right. There you go. That's a little bit more of getting to know each other. Coming up next, why was my wife Jen stuck at TSA for an hour and a half this morning already?
Oh, wow.
I'll tell you next. First, though, Miles Smith and Stargazing. My wife, Jen, she's been gone to a conference.
Yeah.
And she's been in Las Vegas, and she was flying back this morning. She was on a 6 a.m. flight. Almost missed her flight.
How?
Ooh.
Well, Chantel, it turns out on Sunday, Jen called me and said, I'm trying to check in to the hotel here. Will you open up your wallet and see if my ID is in there?
But she got to Vegas.
Glad you brought that up.
Yeah.
You know, this has happened before to the two of us because of Clear.
Right.
You don't get your ID checked.
No, you just need your boarding pass.
They just check your eyes and walk on in. She didn't realize she didn't have her ID until she checked into the hotel. I had her ID since last Saturday at the Sabrina Carpenter concert because you can't bring bags in the Delta Center.
And you didn't think to, like, overnight the ID to Vegas?
I said, do you want me to? And she's like, well, I got here.
I could probably make it back.
Let's roll the dice and see what happens.
It's Vegas, baby.
It's Vegas.
You're kidding.
Because there was a time, actually, that I flew from here to Vegas and back again without an ID.
That's crazy.
I remember
because
this.
Because I had Clear and I'm old enough with my with this great looks that no one carded me the whole time in Vegas.
Isn't that crazy?
At the table.
You made it to Vegas without an ID and you were able to do stuff?
I made it to Vegas. I saw a Bruno Mars concert.
Yep.
Wow.
I played the craps table.
Wow.
He did.
Oh, I did it all.
He did.
And I flew home without an ID.
They said,
one of my favorite
we
stories.
Know who you are.
Crazy. So Jen was like, I'm feeling pretty lucky. It worked for you. Let's see what happens.
Yeah.
It didn't work the same way.
No.
She got tagged this morning on Clear. Every once in a while, you get the random search where you have to show like a photo ID.
Yeah.
And she had nothing but a picture I sent of her. They ended up for an hour and a half going through all of it. She got sent to the special room.
She got sent to the principal's office.
Have you ever been in the special
room?
I've
never been in the special room.
Oh, TSA has these special rooms you go into. They're like
metal table?
They feel like interrogation rooms.
Yeah.
Yeah, and they look through like everything.
Can I get you a root beer, kid?
Yeah, it's like they put the hot light on you.
Yeah.
We'll let you sweat for a minute.
Where's your ID?
Yeah,
I don't know.
She just texted. She got on the flight, but
wow.
That's wild.
Quick reminder. Check for the ID before you travel.
Facts. Yep.
Little life hack for you.
Not a bad idea.
Yeah. All right, Jake, what do we have coming up?
Hey, I've got a word from our friends in Pelly.
Oh.
Yeah.
Jake's word of the day.
Tuesday's greetings, class.
Was that a yawn, professor, or what was?
I thought he hurt himself.
No, I just walked into the room.
Oh, that was excitement.
Oh.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Every day I wake up and I get out of bed and say, another bright day.
Me too.
Another opportunity to learn.
Yes.
Class, let's take some roll. John.
Here.
Chantel.
Here.
Perfect. The whole gang's here. It's time for the word of the day. Today's word of the day is brought to you by our French friends.
Oh.
Today's word of the day is recherché.
I'm sorry?
Recherché?
Recherché. Have you heard of recherché? Does anyone know the definition
of
recherché?
So we're learning French now instead of English?
I know. But this is a commonly used word in the English vernacular.
This is a commonly used word.
Recherché. In the higher academics, yes.
Recherché is the cousin to Australian breakdancer Ray Gunn.
Recherché.
Of course, yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. I believe it's the catchphrase of anyone who steals and is sneaky about it. They always, like, they're up on top of the roof and they're like, recherché. And then they run off.
Oh!
With, like, their mustache. Recherché.
Their little handlebar.
Yes.
Of course, yes. Recherché. Well, truth be told, recherché is an adjective.
Oh.
Recherché is not what either of you said. Recherché actually means something that is exquisite. Choice, very fancy, a bit rare, perhaps pretentious, or overblown and unnecessary.
Why are you looking at me?
Well, John's a little recherché.
To be honest, John, I think the tux that you wear every morning to work might be a little recherché.
Yeah.
Or a 500-year-old bottle of wine, that might be recherché. Or taking your private jet to avoid traffic. That is today's word of the day, recherché.
Jake's word of the day!
Has anyone heard that word before?
No.
Okay.
Someone has.
Made up.
What do you have coming up, Chantel?
How long can you pay attention for? We've kind of hit a point where if you're staring at a screen, you're probably looking at more than one.
Yeah.
And I would have to agree. I'm always looking at my laptop and my phone and my TV, but there is never just one.
I love, at my desk, I have two screens. And it's the greatest thing in the world.
Yeah.
The fact that I used to do things with one screen seems insane at this point. Yeah.
It's crazy. Well, the average Gen Zer checks their phone 6 times during a TV show. I check my phone 1 time during a TV show because I never put it down. It's like I spend all of this time looking for the perfect show.
Yeah.
I start it and then I go, perfect, let me settle into Instagram. Anyone else?
Why do we do this?
You know, I don't scroll on socials, but I love getting me some IMDb while watching.
That's okay. I feel like that's allowed.
Go read that trivia. Go start stalking all the stars.
Exactly.
Yeah. When they say 6 times per show, that means per episode, not like you start the show and binge it and you only check 6 times. Oh, that means, you're picking up your phone quite a lot. Millennials check their phone 5 to 6 times. Baby boomers 3. Baby boomers don't even know where their phone is. They set it down somewhere.
Stop it.
It's on silent. People were asked how long they can watch something before they get bored or they want to multitask. For a movie, it's 15 minutes.
So sad.
Man.
Isn't that crazy?
That's why you got to go out to the movie theater.
Yeah.
It helps you keep that phone
you
away.
Keep focus.
You focus. You just lose yourself in the movie for a little bit.
The average podcast listener, 14 minutes, 36 seconds.
They're going to scroll while listening to the podcast?
Yeah, but you'll have their attention for 14 minutes.
I have a really hard time actually like listening to the spoken word and doing things.
Oh, yeah.
Like if I'm trying to type or I don't do work and then I have like a podcast or some sound in the background, unless it's music. I can't focus on both.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah.
I know that they say, like, because we consume so much content so quickly, like for TikToks and Instagram and things, you can hold someone's attention for, I want to say it was like 7 seconds. Like, you have 7 seconds to, like, get someone's attention.
So we've lost everyone by now.
Yeah, we're done.
That's it.
Our brains are mush
at this point.
I know. Crazy.
There's a marketing agency out there.
Uh-huh.
That just ranked the world's sexiest bald men.
Oh, wow.
Great.
And if you're new to the show, I'm bald. I talk about it often.
Yeah.
Sure.
It's not my favorite attribute, but it's something I'm dealing with. It's a cross I bear.
Yeah.
It's all right.
And I was like, let me take a look at this and let me see who they got.
Right.
Because then I could feel like I'm in some good company. Like for a long time, like whenever someone would talk about a sexy bald man, the only one they'd ever reference was Bruce Willis.
All we had
was like Bruce Willis. And bad news, I look more like Phil Collins than Bruce Willis.
Yeah.
So it never really went well for me. So I'm like, all right, marketing agency, who you got? First place?
Uh-huh.
Prince William.
What?
He's not bald. I mean, yet.
No, he's bald. No, he's bald, he's just but he's not, no, but he's not
saying,
the sexiest bald
I'm
guy.
You can't be considered bald until you've leaned in. He hasn't leaned in yet.
Also, listen, Prince William, when he was like in high school, I know that he was a heartthrob.
Yeah.
But let's be honest.
Let's be real.
Well.
Come on.
Yeah.
Wow. That's number one.
That's number one.
Okay, starting strong.
Do you know who made number six on this list?
Well, let's just Phil Collins.
Yeah.
I wish Phil Collins made this list.
Okay.
Danny DeVito.
Oh.
So you're telling me, marketing agency, that when you all sat together in the conference room and you said, hey, let's talk sexy bald guys. Who you got?
Yeah.
Someone said, Danny DeVito. And you went,
question mark?
We'll put it on the board. Let's see if we can have it better.
And then he made it to number six.
They couldn't come up with nine better people?
Wow. Listen, I love Danny DeVito.
Yeah.
He's hilarious.
Yeah.
You know, really great actor.
Yeah.
Hot. I don't know about that. What about Mr. Clean? Is Mr. Clean up
Mr.
there?
Mr. Clean did not make the list.
No fictional
what about,
characters?
Like, The Rock?
The Rock came in second.
Okay.
Okay.
Which is kind of now the go-to bald dude.
Yeah, right.
He is,
right.
He is.
Shaq came in third, which kind of hurts also.
Yeah.
I mean, no offense to Shaq. Now, fourth is Kelly Slater, who's a famous surfer.
Oh, okay.
He's a good-looking dude.
Yeah.
Followed by Terry Crews.
Yeah.
Brooklyn Nine-Nine.
Sure. Handsome guy.
I was like, okay.
What about that guy that everybody said that you looked like? The Jeter.
Jeter, yeah.
Derek Jeter did not make the top 10.
Wow. You're kidding.
So you wouldn't have made the top 10.
No.
That's offensive.
Danny DeVito
really
did.
You kind of look like him.
So Terry Crews, stud, good-looking dude.
Sure.
Then Danny DeVito.
Okay.
Wow.
Nice.
Followed by Samuel L. Jackson. We don't have anyone new. Marketing agency.
Yeah.
There's no one new out
there.
Nobody
new who has lost their hair.
What about J.K. Simmons?
J.K. Simmons did not make it, but you know who did? Stanley Tucci. Top 10.
I like
most
Tucci.
Baldalicious babes. Stanley Tucci came in at number 9.
Put some respect on Tucci's name. He's great.
Listen, I'm not saying I don't love him as an actor from The Hunger Games.
This is incredible.
Did you see the bald skit on SNL?
I did.
Yeah.
I did see
it was
the bald
so
skit.
So good.
Did you see
it? Was
it?
So funny
no.
With Bill Burr.
Bill Burr, who's a comedian who's bald, they had everyone in SNL, the whole cast wearing bald caps, and they sang a song about being bald. I actually have a bit of it. Here
yeah,
you go.
Pull it up.
We are bald men. Yes, it's true. We can do all the things that you can do. We are bald men. We're strong and proud. We are bald and we're singing a song aloud. We are bald.
Did you feel seen?
And that is
that. No, it made me just sad.
Oh, come on.
I'm sorry, John.
It's a
hey,
rally.
Now you have someone new to look up to. Danny DeVito.
Yeah. Get out of here. This is ridiculous right now. Danny DeVito.
He's great.
Six. Baldalicious babe. Snow is falling now. Downtown Salt Lake City. Told you traffic's been bad all morning long. Just
That's
looking
bad.
To see if where it's good. It's not anywhere. So.
Yeah.
Slow it down. I'm trying to... I'll tell you, Jake's having us record every break. And for the life of me, he tells me 3 seconds before we go on each and every time.
Well, in Jake's defense, he said, I would like to record every break today.
I can't remember. Mm-hmm.
Me either.
And then
I'm
trying
a hard
to like,
time.
Put the camera up each and every
I can't
time.
I can't be the responsible one.
Jen's gone. Her car is at the airport. My car is in the shop. So I've been driving my mother-in-law's car around.
Mm-hmm.
And I took the kids to Shields on Sunday. And we were inside. And Ella wanted to buy something. And she realized she had left her wallet back in the car. In my mother-in-law's car. And I said, you know what? Stay inside. I'll just run out. It was packed. The parking lot was crazy. I'm like, just hang out with Liam. I go out there. And I think I see my mother-in-law's car. And I'm clicking the little clicker. Click, click, click.
Uh-huh.
And then I'm trying the handle. And it's not working. And I'm like, gosh, is it stuck? I was using the back door, maybe the front door. And I go over and I'm click, click, click. And I'm like violently trying to open the door. And this woman behind me yells, hey, what are you doing to my car?
Oh, my gosh. You were breaking into someone's car?
I was. Yep. Wasn't the car that I was supposed to be at all. It was a nice car. It was a Porsche McLaren that I was.
Wait.
Really?
Yeah.
On what planet Did you think you arrived to Shields in a Porsche?
Well, it was like a white SUV, and I came in a white SUV. It looks somewhat similar.
That's all you remember?
That is that is offensive to all Porsche drivers. That you thought a Porsche Cayenne, or whatever you said it was, whatever.
Yeah.
Looked like, what, an Acura?
Yeah.
Nice.
It was white. It had four
doors.
That's
good enough for him.
I'm offended.
Wow.
So I turn around, and she's like now running towards the car because she obviously thinks I'm breaking into it. I go, I'm driving my mother-in-law's car. I don't know what's going on.
Sure, bub. That's what they all say.
Did she call Shields?
No, so she gets in. I walk away, and she's like staring me down.
Okay.
And I go around like this truck, and there's the SUV I was supposed to get into.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I find it, and I get the wallet out of the back, and now it looks like I'm rummaging through another car.
Oh
yeah.
My God.
Grabbing a wallet.
Yeah. Now, yeah, it's success.
Right.
A child's wallet.
Yeah. And she had pulled her car around and was watching me.
I mean.
Wow.
Yes. So now I'm walking back into Shields, and she is slowly driving behind me.
Oh my God!
Which, by the way, what are you gonna do?
I don't know. Maybe.
But she like followed me into Shields to finally at the point where I could get inside. She made the left and disappeared.
Wow!
Wow! She had her phone ready.
I bet she did.
She did not trust you bit. She did not buy your little SUV
story. She didn't buy your story at all.
Man,
I wouldn't either.
I have to start paying better attention.
You really do.
Honestly, like, gosh.
You're going to end up in jail.
I'm going to get shot. That's what's going to happen.
An old lady.
How weird would this be?
Okay.
You're watching a TV show. You're watching a reality show.
Okay.
And you realize that the scene that you're seeing was shot in your apartment.
Like previously to you living there?
Yes.
That's hilarious.
Oh,
isn't that crazy? There's a woman in New York. She was watching the reality show Couples Therapy.
Okay.
Have you seen it?
I literally watched it last night.
I've been telling you to watch it.
Yeah, because it's new on Netflix, right?
Did you like it?
Of course. Yeah, I've seen it
it's
before.
Kind of heavy. Huh. And she realized that the couples, one of the couples actually used to live in her apartment.
Oh, wow.
Wait, Couples Therapy?
Couples Therapy involves couples who go and see a marriage.
Nope. I didn't watch it. I watched Couples Retreat.
My favorite movie of all time.
Yes.
Yeah. So yeah, it just happens, right? It's a reality show.
Yeah.
She just happened to see it. We actually used to have a reality show that was shot in this building.
Yes, Breaking Mormonism, right? Or
Breaking Polygamy. And it was shot right above us.
Oh.
And they didn't actually, the office that the people would come to, they didn't want to use the real office.
Yeah.
So they would use it here. And we would see, like, the way they looked out, it was the same as the way we looked out.
Yeah, just a little higher.
Yeah.
Oh, that's weird.
It was so trippy.
That's cool.
I think it just depends on the reality show. And it would be fun for a lot of them.
Yeah.
But then there's some reality shows, Cops, that maybe I don't want to be seen in.
Yikes.
Yeah. Chantel's like, sit down. I've got a life hack for you.
Yeah, okay? I do. I've got quite the hack. So I've talked about this before on the show. I have two boys,
yep.
And they don't eat super well. Like, when it's time to eat a meal, they would rather do anything else. They want to play, they want to not eat, and it's been a struggle. But yesterday, we had wrestling practice, and so before wrestling, I feed them dinner, and we do the whole deal because we weren't going to get home until 8 p.m. So I was like, let's do dinner before.
Oh, yeah.
So I feed them dinner, and we go to wrestling practice, and I'm like, perfect, when we get home, we can do bath and bed. Well, when we got home, my boyfriend brought over Chick-fil-A for me and him. Mm-hmm. And I was like, oh, don't worry. The boys already ate. Like, you don't need to get them
anything.
They're fine. And so they're taking their bath. They're getting their jams on. They're doing their routine. They come downstairs, and I'm like eating Chick-fil-A. And I'm like, uh-oh.
Yeah, yikes.
Just got caught.
Ooh. I'm busted.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, no, it's okay. Once you finish getting all ready for bed, you'll have your Chick-fil-A snack.
Yeah.
And I'm like, I got this. So I pop in some chicken nuggets in the oven.
Okay.
I finished eating my Chick-fil-A.
Yeah.
I've got their Chick-fil-A sauce, whatever. I refilled my Chick-fil-A cardboard box with oven
That's brilliant.
Chicken nuggets.
Wow.
That's brilliant.
And I put them in and I said, here you go. They ate it just fine.
Oh, yeah. They would have no clue.
Dipped it in their Chick-fil-A sauce. They had no idea.
And let's be honest, Chick-fil-A sauce covers all sins anyway.
It really does.
Like, it's true. Yeah.
Anyway, and they gave me this thought. I was like, yeah. Wow, I should be saving all my Chick-fil-A containers.
Oh my gosh.
My kids would eat so much. Did they eat all the nuggies? Yes, yeah. They did. Anyway, I was like, wow, I could save myself so much time and money. Yeah.
You're going to have a Chick-fil-A drawer?
I'm going to have a Chick-fil-A drawer. Just like Jake's mom who saves the paper plates.
Right, yes.
I'm going to start saving my Chick-fil-A boxes.
Oh, no.
So that I can refill them after I've made chicken nuggets at home.
It's brilliant.
If it works, it works.
That's right.
It works?
Yeah.
Hey, coming up, a brand new pickup line with your pickup line at 9. And yes, it is Thanksgiving themed. The snow is falling, but let's heat it up in here. And that's not even my pickup line.
No.
Wow.
That's just I just ooze it.
That's,
you know,
just
what
a
I'm
segue.
Saying?
He's just like a...
Just how I roll.
Like a, just a guy of pickup lines.
Every day at this time, we do your pickup line at 9. Just something to flirt with during that day. Maybe with someone you like. Maybe with your partner. You got to keep that romance alive. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And since Thanksgiving is just 16 days away,
yeah.
I'm doing Thanksgiving pickup lines. Hey, girl.
Hey.
Glad I brought out the oven mitts.
Oh, no. I'm nervous.
Because you're too hot to handle.
Okay. Oh. All right. It wasn't too bad.
What did you think?
Could have been worse.
What is
it wrong
with you?
It could have been worse.
You?
I don't know.
You know what? You might go low, but I go high.
Oh, do you?
Right.
Really?
All right. Coming up next, have you ever left a concert or sporting event early? What's your number one reason? I bet we all have the same one. Have you ever left a concert or sporting event early just to beat traffic?
Oh,
what
yeah.
am I, 80?
I hate myself for how often I do this. I do.
You don't just leave like early. You'll leave at the beginning of the fourth quarter.
I leave after the headliner sings the first song.
Yeah.
I'm like, oh, all right.
Like,
we
John
good.
Does all it. This work to get to a concert to see, I don't know, Sabrina Carpenter.
Yeah.
And he's like, yep, two songs. Okay, I better get headed or else I might get stuck in traffic.
Yeah.
Like,
I get it.
I got it.
I get
I was
it.
There.
No,
I got,
I got
a photo.
The gist. Yeah.
I hate it. And my, I feel so bad because my kids are concert. They're like,
yeah, they're
they should
kids.
Go with Chantel.
They We would have
you would
quite the time.
Because they want to stay to the end of these shows. And I'm like, oh, but that means we're going to get there over to the gateway and we're going to get stuck in the parking structure for like an hour and 15.
Yeah.
Then it's still, you know, just to get on the freeway, it's another 30 minutes. And now we're talking 2 hours after this late show.
What are you, where, what venue are you leaving that it takes an hour and 15 minutes to get out of the
parking structure?
Parking structure.
Oh, you, Delta? I know, but you
where
get
do
to
you park?
You get to concerts earlier than me.
I don't get there that early.
Usually I'm down at the basement. I'm down there next to the Earth's core.
Oh, right, right, right.
It takes forever to get out of that
Yeesh.
Thing. Yeah.
Well, why don't you stop parking there and you park in one of the other lots?
Someone asked people if they've ever left a big event early just to beat traffic. 80% of us have done it.
Yeah.
I will leave early from my house to beat traffic to get there.
74% of us say we would go to more events if we knew traffic wouldn't be such a nightmare. It's one of the reasons why I don't go to the amphitheater.
Yeah.
Hey, that's what I was going to say. The only venue that I know stinks to get out of the parking lot is the amphitheater.
Yeah.
But America First has done like a pretty good job. They actually have people directing now.
It helps.
Or Utah First, sorry.
But it's just a natural thing. There's always going to be a ton of backup.
You... This is the part that I don't understand. Why would you spend the money on the ticket to go to the event to leave early?
I get stressed the minute we sit down.
Wow.
About leaving.
Yeah.
Well, you know what it is? Early to bed, early to rise. That's who you are.
That's right. That's why every morning.
And with daylight savings at 4 p.m., your clock just starts ticking.
I like my dinner at 5, my concert's over by 6,
and
my warm milk at 7.
You
in bed, lights
so
out at 8.
Lame.
What do you have coming up, Chantel?
Is this hot or not? It's impossible to hop on every single trend unless you live here in Utah, because we love trends.
We're good
and
at
we're
it.
Just like,
yeah,
right.
I just want to take it and I want this trend to be cool. But as far as the three of us in studio go, I want to go like, what do we think is hot? What's not as far as trends go?
Oh, okay.
Ooh.
Adult coloring books, hot or not?
I don't do it, but I appreciate it.
Yeah, I have friends who do the adult coloring books. I think that it's fun.
I think they had their moment, but I think they're out now.
You don't think they're definitely cool.
Yeah,
you're right. Yeah.
Kombucha?
Kombucha.
I love kombucha.
Same. I'm getting my own flavor of kombucha made this month.
No, you're not.
Yes, by Sun Tea Kombucha up in Ogden. They're making a flavor for our band.
The fact that I couldn't even say it properly shows that for me, it's not. I tried it one time and I was like, ugh.
There's good it's and delicious. Bad. I will tell you, the other problem now is a lot of it has so much sugar in it.
Yeah.
That's the one you
That's
like.
Preferred.
Preferred is more sugar. Fantasy football, hot or not?
It has jumped the shark in a big way.
Jumped the shark.
In the sense that like it's so mainstream now.
Yeah.
There used to be a time when it was just for
like
some
the elitist
sport. Yeah, it was elitist, and now it's everyone. Yeah.
Now it's just sports betting.
My boyfriend is in two fantasy football leagues, and that guy can't put his phone down.
Yep.
Like, he's constantly tracking players and switching things around, and I never had a problem with fantasy football before, and now I'm like, oh, well, it's a little time-consuming.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Now, when he
drafts... obnoxious.
When he drafts his team, does he go and hang out with his friends and do the whole draft
live?
Yeah,
they do it from their own homes. They live in different cities, different states. But yeah, I remember he ordered wings and was like, it was a whole thing.
Oh, yeah.
Seems too stressful.
Yeah. So for me, fantasy football, I'm going to go not. Ozempic. Hot. You know me. I did semaglutide.
I know.
It worked really well for me.
Are you wondering, are we saying is it still as popular today as it was?
I think it's more, I think it's more mainstream. I think it's in the beginning, like when I did semaglutide and when Ozempic and those things first came out, I think there was a huge negative connotation where it was like, oh my gosh, they cheated or they're taking a miracle shot that's the way it's going to come back and this, that, and the other. Now you can like basically get it over the counter.
No,
like, you don't
me,
even
though.
Have to have a provider almost anymore.
So many people, you know they're on the shot because they've lost 40 pounds in 3 weeks.
Right.
Yep.
And you're like, hey, you look great. Thanks, just eating right.
No, you're not.
Just say you took a shot.
Well, and here's my thing.
Yeah.
With Ozempic, semaglutide, tirzepatide, all of those different things, I think that it's still so important to get it from a provider.
100%.
I think that the websites who are selling it, that stresses me out.
Yeah.
That's where I'm like, ooh, I don't know about that. But if you're getting it from like a med spa or someone local or your doctor, I think that's so much safer because they do track it based on your weight and how much you should be taking in your doses. When you're just getting free reign to give yourself as much as you want, like, I think that's where you start having the problems.
Sure.
But
yeah.
For me, Ozempic is still hot.
I agree.
Vaping.
No.
Not.
No.
So annoying. No. I'm sorry to anybody who vapes. I respect people who quit smoking and pick up vaping instead, but now it's like,
they're also saying,
you just got to go back to smoking.
Well, they're saying a lot of these, there's big health problems with vaping.
Yeah, right? Exactly.
Everyone thought like, oh, it's a healthy alternative. It's like, well, no.
100%.
No, not really.
Cybertrucks, I'd say they're
hot.
I think when they first came out, they were not.
Yeah.
I think now they're
hot.
Stanley Cups, I think not.
Yeah.
I think the Hydro Flask has taken over in a big way.
I think like Stanley Cup sold out in such a way.
Yeah.
Like they're everywhere. You know what I mean?
I think 100%. We're on the cusp of a new cup. We need something.
Exciting.
Something
new. We are ready for something new. And then AI generated influencer content, like influencer anything on social media. We are
bad.
In the anti-influencing era right now. So I would say it's not hot.
Yeah.
Have you ever had a guest stay at your house and you're like, well, that was a weird thing you did?
Yeah.
Sure.
I once had my ex-husband's best friend live with us, and he cooked bacon every day, and it drove me crazy.
Wow.
Do you remember that?
Oh, yeah. No, it drove you, like,
nuts.
The smell
was,
or the sound?
He was, like, into CrossFit.
He was into the keto.
Keto, CrossFit, whatever.
Yeah.
And, like, I'm telling you, my house reeked of bacon. The bacon was so bad that the cabinet above the oven had like grease on it that I had to scrape off with a rubber spatula.
Oh,
it was horrible.
Nasty.
BuzzFeed had a list of bad house guests.
Oh, great.
Someone had a friend stay over who forgot their toothbrush. So they just used a random loose one they found under the sink.
No.
The homeowner had to tell them, I use that for cleaning.
Yeah,
that's
if
for
it's
the
under
dog.
The sink, it's typically for cleaning.
Honestly.
Or- some sort of pet.
Yuck. Someone had a guest going through their garbage and who would pull out perfectly good food that shouldn't go to waste.
Oh, wow.
You know when my mom comes to town?
Yeah.
She'll save like every single piece of leftover, like one bite. And I have...
She's going to heat that up for later.
Well, and then she leaves because she only comes for like 2 days. So then she'll leave and I'll open up and I have a bunch of saran wrap, one bite of food. And I'm like, what are you doing?
She's
like,
saving it for later.
She's like, well, I just thought you might want it later. I'm like, one bite?
It's awesome.
Midnight snack.
Someone had a friend's day over and in the middle of the night, they woke up to them rearranging the furniture to improve the feng shui.
Oh,
That's thoughtful. That's odd.
Your couch needs to be facing this way. No,
it really opens up the room.
I would be so annoyed.
I teased this like a few minutes ago, and this text says, my friend stole my mom's bra when we were 13.
Oh, wow. Yeah, no, that's just bad. Yikes,
that's
dude.
That's weird.
A person said their brother-in-law changed their baby's diaper on the dining table during Thanksgiving dinner.
Okay.
They said, hey, you want a private place? He didn't take the hint, and he didn't want to miss the conversation.
I just can't miss out on this conversation.
I want to know that conversation.
It's so riveting.
Dang.
Literally. Wow. What the heck?
Here's another text that just came in. We gave our older neighbor a key to our house. He offered to walk the dog during the day. He did, but he would also just spend hours watching TV in our house.
What?
With the dog on the couch.
We had a neighbor once growing up that just would make himself at home in our house. Mm-hmm. But we thought he was cool. They were like this young married couple. He was probably in his early mid-20s.
Yeah.
And when he'd get home from work, he was a school teacher. He would just come over and hang out. Like hang out with all the kids. Like he was one of us.
Yeah.
It was so funny.
Wouldn't that be weird now though?
Now I think about it, because my parents were in their late 30s.
Yeah.
I'm like, that would be weird
It'd
to me.
Be strange.
I wouldn't like it.
Chantel, let's follow up one last time with the hot topic.
Yeah,
dressing casual.
Casual or fancy for Thanksgiving? How does your family do it? 76% of Utahns go casual.
Man.
Josh texts us saying, I wear the apron.
Nice.
Okay. Do you wear anything underneath the apron?
Like,
it's the cook.
What's cooking? Good looking.
The guy, that's cool, that's your thing, but I just want to make sure there's some coverage going on. I had a bunch of different texts. One, I talked about how Jen didn't have her ID when she was flying.
Yeah.
I got a text saying Utah now has an app for your ID on the driver's license website. She could have downloaded it and she could have her ID.
Oh.
That needs to be public knowledge.
I know.
Somebody who has a large platform that can share this type of information should do that.
Someone call. Someone call Radio From Hell.
Yeah. people listen to them.
Right. I know my son does. Anyway, Sam's Club. Oh, this is based off of you talking about your life hack.
Ah, yes. My Chick-fil-A cardboard boxes.
Yeah. You were saying you just make chicken nuggets and throw them in Chick-fil-A boxes.
I did it one time after I had just finished my Chick-fil-A.
This text says, Sam's Club has waffle fries and nuggets that taste just like Chick-fil-A.
Yeah.
Yes. No, I've heard of this. And if you air fry the nuggets, they literally do taste like it.
I get those.
I need to find red cardboard boxes on Amazon that I can do this with. Because I don't think if I walk into Chick-fil-A, I don't think they're just going to hand over some boxes.
I'd like 37 boxes, please.
I need them for the month.
Presentation goes a long way.
It does with my kids.
The truth. All right, before we go.
Things to make up.
Things that make you go. Gotta leave you with a fun fact. That's why we do things that make you go, hmm? Something for you to share with your coworkers when you arrive late today.
Oh, nice.
Did you know there's a German word specifically for the weight you gain from overeating?
What is it?
It's called Kummerspeck.
Sorry, one more time.
Kummerspeck.
So you're Kummerspeck? Telling me we got a French word today. Now we got a German word.
It translates into grief bacon, which I think is even better.
This is a German word for everything.
There really is.
Grief bacon?
Kummerspeck.
Kummerspeck. Wow.
Let's wrap this up.
Jake, high or low of today's show?
Hey, I had a whole lot of fun just talking about the weird things that people do in your house.
Yeah, the weird house guests.
Yeah.
That was funny.
Yeah. I think it was interesting going over trends, what's cool, what's not.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I enjoyed learning about Coomer Spec.
Yeah, Coomer Spec. Yeah, yeah,
exactly.
Or Ray Gun.
No.
Jake, have a great day.
You too.
Chantel.
Hey, I'm sticking around.
All right, hang out with Chantel. Don't go anywhere. She's got her choice of songs at 11:40. And then Dylan at 3 o'clock has your tickets to Wicked. Bye-bye.